To solve this logarithmic equation, first we're going to get all of our log base 6 on one side. Now to do that, I'm going to add log base 6 of x minus 1 on both sides. Now those are not like terms, so we're going to keep them separate. Log base 6 of x plus log base 6 of x minus 1, well that's going to be equal to 1. Now that we have our logarithms on the same side, we can simplify them down to one log. This is equivalent to log base 6 of the product x times x minus 1, using the properties of the logarithm. Okay, so now we've isolated the log and we can apply the definition and convert this back to an exponential. So the base here is 6. 6 to this power has to equal that argument. Okay, so 6 to the 1 power has to equal x times x minus 1. Okay, and you can see we get a quadratic here. 6 then equals x squared minus x, getting it equal to 0 by subtracting 6, leaves us with x squared minus x minus 6. Okay, we're going to try to factor this. Yeah, this thing should factor. X and x. 6 breaks up as 2 times 3. 2x and 3x add up to negative x if the 3 is negative and the 2 is positive. Positive 2 times negative 3 certainly is negative 6. Okay, and then you set each factor equal to 0. Come up here. And this tells me x equals negative 2 or x equals 3. So I have two possible solutions, but we know we better check those. When I substitute negative 2 back into the original, I'll have log base 6 of a negative number. Okay, the argument of a logarithm can't be negative, so this is an extraneous solution. I'm going to throw that away. When I substitute 3 in, I'll have log base 6 of 3, and I need to see if that equals 1 minus log base 6 of 3 minus 1, which is 2. And you can see that you could do that on a calculator or something, and you'll see that, yeah, it does work. Okay, so the solution set here consists of one element, and that's 3.